Good morning, my dear friends. So now, today we'll begin with a problem on footing, okay? Isolated footing, okay? So now, what the problem says is now, design an isolated footing for a column 500 mm by 500 mm. In the sense, he has got a column here now, 500 mm by 500 mm, dimension here, given here, in the sense, this dimension is 500 mm, this dimension is 500 mm, okay? It is transmitting an axial load of 1200 kN. In a sense, this column is transmitting a load of 1200 kN. Okay? That column is reinforced with 8 bars of 20 mm 5 bars. Okay, it is reinforced with these many bars, 8 bars. He has given the SPC of the soil. SPC of the soil is a 12 load ton to 12 meter soil. Okay? And he has asked you to use M20 kN of concrete and F250 steel. And he has asked you to design a footing for this to carry a load of 1200 kilometers. Okay, so now solution, begin with the solution. So now, as usual, the first step is calculation of the constraints. Okay, so for M20 kN of concrete, FCK is 20 MPa, and for Fe250 steel, FY yield stress is 250 MPa. Okay, so you can easily find out your XU maximum by D by using your IS code table. Okay, so its value is 0.53. Then, by using this XU max by D value, I think you can easily calculate this RU max. And RU max value I have given here directly, 2.67 Newton per mm square. So now, this is our as usual step. Okay, the first step. So now, the second step is, I will fix up the size of the footing. In a sense, I should know how much is this size, how much is this size. Okay, I will first of all fix up the size of the footing. So now, as you know, he has given the total load acting on the column is 1200. So I will call it as W. Okay, so to this W, I will add the self weight of this footing with W dash. And in our previous class, we have seen self weight of the footing with W dash can be taken as 10% of this W. Am I right now? So it is 10% of this W is 120 kN. In the sense, approximately 120 kN is the self weight of this footing. Okay, so now if I add this W and W dash, I will get the total load. Okay, so total load is W plus W dash. So it will give me 1320. Okay, so now also he has given me the SPC of the soil. SPC of the soil is 12 ton per meter square, micron, or it is 120 kN per meter square. So now, from this, I want to calculate the approximate area required for the footing. Over in the last class, we have seen area of the footing A can be calculated by total load divided by SPC of the soil. Am I right now? So total load I know, it is 1320. SPC of soil also I know, it is 120. Okay, so it will give me 11 meter square. In the sense, 11 meter square area is required for this footing to carry this much load. To carry this much load, I need 11 meter square area. Okay, so now you have to take a decision. The decision is whether you want to provide a rectangular footing or a square footing or a circular footing. Okay, let us assume that I want to give here a square footing. Okay, so if now I want to provide a square footing, but I can easily calculate the size of this square footing. 11 meter square is the area. Okay, so 11 under root, it will give me size of the footing as 3.3 or say 3.4 meter. In a sense, 3.4 meter in this direction, 3.4 meter in this direction. Okay, if I give, it is a square footing. Okay, if at all you want to provide a rectangular footing, I think it can be now done easily. In this level, put somewhere in here now, and you can easily calculate this B. Am I right now? Similarly, if at all you want to have a circular footing, then also you can easily calculate the diameter of that footing by knowing the area. Am I right? So now, 3.4 meter by 3.4 meter is my dimension for the footing. Okay, so now the last step is, now I have calculated the actual upward pressure. under a factor rule of 1.5W. Baba, in sense, I want to know how much is the upward thrust, P naught, ultimate P naught, P naught U. Okay? So it is WU. WU means it is 1.5 times W. Am I right? Divided by area, B into B, 3.4 into 3.4. So Baba, it will give me this much as your upward thrust. Your ultimate upward thrust from the soil is, it is 0.156 Newton per mm square. Okay? So thank you very much. We'll stop it.